Okay, somebody asked me, what do I think about Alaska, and how will Alaska be affected if there's any type of turmoil with the economy? Simply put, I don't think the question is, can Alaska survive an economic collapse? I think the question is, can Americans in the lower 48 survive an economic collapse? Because Alaskans are better equipped to deal with any type of a problem like this than most of the people in the lower 48s. I'm from Michigan. I've been here for 9 months. I have seen people hunt, fish. Most Alaskans have guns. I mean, they have rifles. So, you know, if the economy fell apart, you know, they can just go right down the street. There's the ocean, and they can go fishing, or they can go hunting. I mean, the island's huge. I'm in Ketchikan, Alaska, so there's always food around here. So I don't think it's an issue of survivability here in Alaska. I'm from Michigan, and I'm worried about what's going to happen in places like Michigan. For example, Michigan, although we have plenty of fresh water, a lot of people don't know how to hunt. A lot of people don't know how to fish. So, especially people in the urban areas. So, if food supplies are cut off, and that's very possible since most of the people that I know who live in urban areas and suburban areas rely on major food chains to get food. And food chains are all about using trucks to ship food all across the country. And if the price of gas goes up, the prices for food will skyrocket. And if anything happens and they can't get food out to people, there's no farms in the cities, you know? I mean, we have plenty of farms in Michigan, but, I mean, you have to walk miles and miles and miles to get to farms. And people don't know how to grow their own thing, so the idea of Alaska being in trouble, a lot of people already know how to survive without all the modern amenities. So I think Alaska will be fine. Somebody mentioned that there really wouldn't be chaos. And that was an interesting thing that somebody said. If food supplies are cut off, there will definitely be chaos. Okay? A lot of people rely on the government for a lot of things. Healthcare, food. If something happens and the food supplies are cut off, just remember Hurricane Katrina. Remember New Orleans. You know, now think about that on a massive scale, on an even bigger scale, all across the country. I mean, the idea that people are going to be peaceful, yeah, we're all going to want peace and order, but I mean, you know, when you're hungry and you're starving, I mean, you're willing to do whatever it takes to survive. So, I would like to be optimistic about that, but if things get really bad, people will get desperate and they'll do whatever it takes to survive, to live. So it's something you have to really think about, and that's one of the reasons why I'm currently researching farming, growing things. I'm researching plants. It's something I think we all should start doing. Hopefully it won't get that bad, but I am worried, and if you're smart, so are you.